Okay, shall I start the session? Shall I start the session? Are you able to hear my voice, guys? Everyone, are you able to hear my voice? Can you able to hear my voice, everyone? Okay, let it be. I am starting my session. Okay, I'm going to start the session. Still, I cannot wait for 5 more minutes. Why? Because it's already 11:10. So I'm going to start the session. Today we'll see about the access specifiers. Yesterday we have seen about the constructors. Today we are going to see about the access specifiers. So then what are the way we are going to see? Okay. Listening, everyone? No response from your side. Okay. Okay, I'm sharing my desktop and I'm going to show you how many access specifiers are there in the paint. Access specifiers, what are these access specifiers in the sense? How many access specifiers are there? So in Java there are 4 different type of access specifiers, that is private, protected, default and public. Why we are using these access specifiers, what is the use of these access specifiers, all the things we will let you know. Okay, public, private, protected, default, public are 4 different access specifiers which are used in Java. Normally in C sharp or Edivo.NET we have another access specifier which is nothing but internal also, but in Java we don't have any internal. We have only 4 different type of access specifiers. Those are nothing but private, protected, public and default. In C++ we have 3 access specifiers. We'll see only 3 access specifiers, that is private, protected and public. Whereas in Java we are going to see 4 different type of access specifiers. Now actually what is the use of access specifier? Is it necessary for us to use the access specifier? Can anyone say me what is an access specifier? Sorry. Yesterday I have given you 2 assignments. Everyone did that assignment? Constructor assignment. No, yes, actually why we are going to use those access specifiers, just type it in the chat box guys. If you have any doubts or anything, if you ask any question, please respond to my question and type that answer in the chat box. No, no one don't know what is an access specifier. Say yes or no. No. Okay, let me explain what is an access specifier. The access specifier, in the sense, when we are going to use encapsulation, isn't it? We are going to use encapsulation. Where these access specifiers are used? These are used in encapsulation. These are used in encapsulation. Where they are, these are going to use? These are used in encapsulation. What is encapsulation? Can anyone? What is encapsulation? What is an encapsulation? No one? What is an encapsulation? So now what about the encapsulation? So we are saying that in Java we are going to protect the data, protect the data. In what way we are going to protect the data in Java? So we have been saying that in Java we are going to protect the data. In what way we are going to protect the data? With the help of access specifiers. So in Java, we are, in C++ there is a disadvantage that we cannot protect the data. So in Java we are going to protect the data. In what way we are going to protect the data? With the help of encapsulation. Normally what is an encapsulation? Wrapping of together. Wrapping of data together with its function is nothing but an encapsulation, right? Wrapping up of data together with its functions or modules is nothing but encapsulation. Wrapping up of data together with each wrapping up of data together with its modules or functions is nothing but an encapsulation. Normally, encapsulation is nothing but securing our data. What it is? Securing our data. In what way we are going to secure our data? Securing of data. In what way we are going to provide security for our data? With the help of access specifiers. So, what are the different type of access specifiers we have? We have four different type of access specifiers. They are private, protected, default and public. Now what about private? So first we will see about public. What is a public data access specifier? So generally what people thinks, what is a public? Generally what people might think, what about the public? I mean, whatever public means. As we all know that public is nothing but a, it can be seen by everyone. It can visualize everyone. Isn't it? This is what about public. It means it can be viewed by everyone. So in the same way, the data where you are going to provide can be viewed by everyone with the help of public. It can be visualized by everyone. It can be visualized by everyone. Visualized in the sense it can be seen or it can be used by everyone. Isn't it? It can be seen. It can be seen by everyone in the sense it can be used by everyone. It can be used by everyone. So viewing in the sense where we are going to use these in class or outside of a class. So generally if you take public in general meetings, where we are going to use it, we are exposing it in our TLF, it can be seen, it can be visualized by everyone. But in Java program where we are going to take the terminology, in Java program where we are going to use the terminology, that is in the case of class or outside of the class. It can be used by everyone within the class or outside of the class. So it can be visualized by everyone, and that means it can be seen by everyone in class or outside of the class. So we are going to write the class, isn't it? We are going to write about the class, right? So what is a class? Class is nothing but a combination of variables and methods, right? Class is a combination of variables and methods, isn't it? So these variables, when we declare any variable or any method with access specifier, so that becomes, we are going to protect the data. When we declare any variable or any method with help of access specifier, then we are going to provide security for our data. So this is where we are going to use the access specifier. Now I think understood everyone what is an access specifier, where we are going to use. We are going to use that in a class. Where we are going to use? We are going to use that in a class. Understood everyone about public access specifier? So this is what access specifier, that is about prior, public. Public in the sense it can be visualized by everyone, or it can be used by everyone inside of the class or outside of the class. And coming to the class, class is nothing but a combination of variables and methods. When we declare any variable or any method with the help of access specifier, then we are going to provide security for the data. How we are going to provide security? How we are going to provide security? So with the help of access specifiers, with the help of access specifiers, we are going to provide security for our data. Right. So while we are going to provide security, then what about the private, protected, default? So public can be accessed by everyone, or it can be visualized by everyone. So there we are finding one drawback. There itself we are getting one drawback, isn't it? So it can be used by everyone. There itself it is nothing but a drawback. So what we need to do? We have to modify it. We have to modify it. How we are going to modify that? With the help of private. With the help of private. It is absolutely different from public. It is absolutely different from public. It means it cannot be visualized. It cannot be private. In a sense, data should be hiding, isn't it? The data should be kept in the secret mode. So that's why it cannot be visualized by anyone. It should not be visualized by anyone. So it cannot be used inside or outside of the class. It cannot be used inside or outside of the class. It means it cannot be used inside of the class, or it cannot be used outside of the class. That is nothing but private. So it is dead opposite to the public. It is simply dead opposite to the public. Public in the sense everyone can see it or anyone can visualize it, whereas a private, it cannot be visualized. So the data should be in protected mode. The data will be in the more protective. No one cannot see the data, or no one cannot share that data. No one cannot share that data. That is nothing but private access specifier. Okay. Once again, I am repeating, access specifiers are nothing but they are used data to be in a protected manner. It means no one cannot visualize our data, no one cannot see our data. For that purpose, we are going to use these access specifiers. So there are four different type of access specifiers. There are public, private, protected, and default. So in C++ already we have public, private, and protected. Whereas in Java we have increased one more access specifier, which is nothing but default. So totally there are four access specifiers, which are nothing but private, protected, public, and default. Public in a sense it can be visualized by everyone. It can be visualized by everyone. It can be visualized by everyone in the sense it can be seen by everyone. The data which is present in the form of public can be visualized, can be seen, and can be accessed anywhere in the program. Can be used and can be accessed anywhere in the program. So with the help of these, there is a loss of losing the data. There is a chance of stealing the data. All these problems may occur when we use public access specifier. So and private in this cannot be visualized by anyone or everyone. So the data should be in the hidden form only. Suppose when you have written any class, when you are taking the private, when you have taking the private access specifier with the variables, So no one can see that data. No one can see that data. No one is going to visualize that data. So that is nothing but private access specifier. That is nothing but private access specifier. Okay, understood everyone? No? Yes or no? Any doubts up to private and public? Any doubts? No answer. Okay. So now what about protected? So protected in the sense, now in the starting of the class, what we are going to write at the starting of the class, before writing the class, what we are going to write? Before writing the class, what we are going to write? We are going to write packages, right? We are using packages. What type of packages we are going to use? Import java dot util dot star, isn't it? And import java dot io dot star. So these are the packages we are going to use, isn't it? So suppose in one package you have declared one class. In this package you have declared one class, and that class is a combination of variables and methods. So in this class you have declared one variable using protected. In this class you have used one variable You have declared one variable rather than using, I will say, you have declared one variable using protected. So the same variable can be used in import java.io.star package also. So the same variable can be used in other package also. Now we are saying, we are discussing that the same variable can be used in another package. But what about the difference between public and protected? The same public is also, we are saying, it can be used by anywhere or anyone, isn't it? But whereas this public is, it is a global variable. What it is? It is a global variable. It can be used by anyone or everywhere inside a class or outside of the class. But whereas protected, it should be used for only certain purpose. So before starting of the class, we are going to write the packages. So in packages, we are going to see that we have declared one variable using protected. The same variable can be used in another package also. Another package in the sense, same kind of package, we can use that variable. Okay, import java.io.star, the same variable can be used in another package also. So now what about the default? What about the default? Same, it is quite opposite to protected. It is quite opposite to protected. The default access specifier is used so protected can be used for using two different packages, whereas it is used only within one package. The variable which is declared in one package cannot be used out of package. So this is nothing but default access specifier. The default access specifier is used only within one package. The variable which is declared in one package cannot be used in other package. So opposite to the public is private, whereas opposite to the protected is default. It cannot be used outside of the package. So this is nothing but access specifiers. Yeah, now I got it. Up to now my computer is in trucking mode. Okay. So private, protected, public. So public in the sense it can be visualized by anyone or it can be used by everyone within the class or outside of the class, isn't it? and public in the sense protected. Protected in the sense it can, before starting of the class we are going. Now if we find the difference between the class as well as if you find the difference between public and private, what is public? It can be visualized or it can be used by everyone. What is private? It cannot be visualized by anyone. So how you are going to access these private variables? How we are going to access these private variables? So how we are going to access these private variables with the help of getter and setter method. With the help of getter and setter method, you are going to access these private variables. Then what about public? How you are going to access this public access specifier? So public, private, protected, default. How you are going to access this protected? So before starting of the class, we are going to write the packages, right? Import java.util.tar, import java.io.star, all these packages. So before writing this package itself, if you want to use any variable outside of that package or within another package, so then you can use this protected access specifier. So public is in the sense within the class or outside of the class, whereas protected in the sense within the same package or outside of the package, and default in the sense only within that package, only within that package. Now we'll take one table diagram to visualize this. Okay, I think everyone understood, right? No? Yes? So here what I am going to use, within the same class, within the another class, within the package. Within same package. within same package and within another package. So how many access specifiers we have? We have four different type of access specifiers: public, and here itself I will be writing a private, protected, default. Okay, so within that I'll divide these also. Now within the class, public can be used within its class, right? Within another class, within the same package, within another package. Anyone, the public can be used. Private, it can be used only within the class. Protected, it can be used within the class. Default, it can be used within the class. Now within another class, private cannot be used, right? Protected, within another class. Yes, sorry, yes, right, it can be used. Within another class it cannot be used, but whereas within another package it can be used. Within same package it can be used, within another package it can be used, but within the same package it cannot be used within another class, rather than it cannot be used within another package also. Within another class, no, it cannot be used. Within the same package, within the same package it can be used, within another package it cannot be used. So this is the sample description table of access specifiers. Okay, understood everyone? The visualization of that, visualization of access specifiers. So once again I am going to explain this description. Access specifier, it accessibility within the class, within another class, within the same package and within another package. Access specifiers: public, private, protected and default. So wherever we are going to use, within the same class or within the another class, how we are going to access those access specifiers, all the things I have done within the form, have framed within the form of a table. Understood everyone? Have you any doubts? Okay, so this is about access specifiers. This is about access specifiers. Okay, so guys, I am seeing that please log in to dlms.apssdc.in website. I think no one are registering or no one are doing the access in that website. I'm checking the management, I'm checking how many users are logging into it, all the things I'm going to check, but no one are going dlms.apssdc.in. This is the link, please follow that link, please update with that link. Okay, so today we have discussed about the access specifiers. It is a very less topic, it's a very small topic, but its impact is very huge in Java. Its impact is very huge in Java. As though it is a very less topic, it shows more impact in the concepts of Java, isn't it? So what we have discussed so far for today, so access specifiers. Here we are going to use these access specifiers. So while discussing the OOPS concepts, object-oriented programming concepts, what we have discussed, how many object-oriented programming principles are there? There are mainly four object-oriented programming principles. What are they? Abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism, right? So what is meant by abstraction? Hiding of data or implementation of the data. It is nothing but abstraction. So tomorrow we will discuss about the abstract methods and the interfaces in detail, explanation about abstraction as well as interfaces. Tomorrow we are going to discuss. Okay, so encapsulation can be implemented with the help of access specifiers. What are access specifiers? The visibility of data can be hidden with the help of access specifiers. Okay, so that is nothing but access specifiers. Now what is access modifier? Access specifier and access modifier are two different. Access specifier are nothing but four. What are they? Public, private, protected and default. These are nothing but access specifiers. So whatever the theory I have explained, so that the same thing I have represented in the pictorial representation. Okay, understood everyone? Having any doubts? Have you any doubts up to this topic? So if you have any doubts, or if you are registering in that website, if you are not going to get anything, please keep in the chat box so that we will discuss from tomorrow. So if you have any doubts also, please post in the in this chat box. Okay, so far we have discussed this access specifier modulability, access specifier accessibility, all the things, right? Isn't it? So guys, did you understand any topic up to now? So far if you didn't understand any topic, we'll discuss now. Otherwise if we go deep into the topics, we are not able to learn the topics. We cannot follow up our concepts. Why? Because already it is, I think it is our 29th day. It is our 29th day. Still we have only 11 more days, 12 more. Okay, no problem. So that many days we have to complete the syllabus. So that's why I'm asking, still more, if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in chat box so that I can clear you. So the topics what we are going to discuss from tomorrow is some little advanced concepts. What are they? They are little bit advanced. Okay, so that's why if you have any doubts, please post in the chat box so that we can clear your doubts. Okay, understood everyone guys? So if you want, you can take this picture representation. So if you want, you can take this picture representation and you can view it anytime. So from tomorrow onwards, I will discuss some more little advanced concepts based on the topics. Okay, so for today I think no doubts, right? So yesterday I have given you one assignment. How many did that assignment about constructors, all the things? No one? Yesterday we have discussed about the constructor, right? So using the scanner class, I have given you one assignment to write that, to execute that assignment by using scanner class. No one? Okay, no problem. Please go through once access specifiers, access modulability, all the things. So tomorrow we'll discuss about little advanced concepts such as abstract classes, abstract methods, and what is an interface, how we are going to implement that interface, how we are going to implement that abstract classes, all the things in tomorrow's class. Okay. So still more, we have 5 minutes of time. So still anything there to discuss with you? Still anything pending or any type of things to discuss? No, no replies. Okay.
Threat has been detected. Threat has been detected. Threat has been detected.
So tomorrow we'll discuss about the abstract class, abstract methods, as well as interfaces. Why we are going to use these abstract classes. So in inheritance, I think we have discussed that multiple inheritance is not possible. Isn't it? Multiple inheritance is not possible. So how we are going to implement that multiple inheritance in Java? With the help of interfaces. With the help of interfaces, we are going to implement that multiple inheritance in Java. So tomorrow we'll see how we are going to implement that multiple inheritance. Actually, what is an inheritance? Deriving the features of the parent class is nothing but an inheritance, isn't it? So there are different type of inheritance also. Okay, multiple inheritance, how we are going to follow this multiple inheritance? By using interfaces, by using interfaces. So tomorrow we'll discuss about the interfaces in detail. Okay. So thank you one and all for listening to the class, as well as if you have any doubts, please post into the chat box. And in the similar way, please try to log in into the dlms.apssdc.in website also. Okay, thank you one and all.